How y'all doing today? Jesus, he's a wonder in my soul. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He is a wonder in my soul. It is good to be in the house of the Lord again. We're in a Hampton Inn today, this morning, having service. We're believing and trusting in God. And I want you all to be prayerful and to be more when we need to be in God rather than when we be in ourselves. How many people glad that the Lord woke you up this morning? How many people glad that you're in the land of the living? How many people glad? I want to know how many people glad today that you're in the land of the living. He woke me up this morning. He started me on my way. Woke me up this morning. And he started me on my way. I'm so glad, I'm so glad, I'm so glad. He woke me up this morning. And he started me on my way. He woke me up this morning. And he started me on my way. I'm so glad, I'm so glad, I'm so glad. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to start the service today. I'm going to start reading from 1 Corinthians, the 7th chapter. I'm going to start at the first verse. Now concerning the matters about which you wrote, it is good for a man not to have sexual relationship with a woman, but because of the temptation of sexual immorality, each man should have his own wife and each woman her own husband. The husband should give to his wife her conjugal and right, and likewise the wife to her husband. For the wife does not have authority over her own body, but the husband does. Likewise, the husband does not have authority over his own body, but wife devoted yourself to prayer. But then come together again, so Satan may not tempt you because of. Satan shall not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. In the beginning, God wanted man to live life in this relationship, if you would. He wanted man and woman to live life eternally. That was incumbent upon God to do that because God loved us so much. He made it absolutely clear that man could not and should not and would not eat of the forbidden fruit. He could have everything in the land, everything, but he should not eat of the forbidden fruit. And in relationships today, we have people who love to have this, that, and the other. They're selfish. They're not satisfied with having one Porsche. They're not satisfied with having one house, if you would. And they're not satisfied with having one wife. But the Bible, according to the Bible says we should seek his kingdom. And all these things will be added. All we have to do is hold to the principles of God, and God will be there for us. Letting go and letting God in our life will always be a plus for us. We not need to yield to man and his devices. In this world today, there are many people are yielding to man and man's devices. Today, we are afraid. We are so afraid of living a life full of sin, full of lust, full of immensely living for the world and not doing the things that God wants us to do. Letting go and letting God is a hard thing for us. I'm going to start getting into the subject the more. Everybody is called to do something. When man first came on the earth, all he was called to do is not eat of that forbidden fruit. That's the only thing he had to do, is not to eat of that forbidden fruit. That's the only thing. That was his only thing he had to do. Everything else, he was good. The only thing he had to do is not eat of the forbidden fruit. And what happened? Eve ate the forbidden fruit because she was deceived by the devil, the serpent, the snake. And then she went to Adam, and he was deceived by the woman. And he didn't like so. Now we live in a world, the Bible said that he wants us to live. He wants us to be fruitful and multiply. Fruitful and multiply. That means get married to your wife and have children. Boom, that's it. And then live for him. Live in integrity. Live in modesty. Live in love. And do the things you need to do. But in this world today, in relationship, if you will, the relationship of a man and a woman, the institution of God, if you would, everybody is trying to fend for themselves. When people are not happy where they are, when people don't want to do it God's way, but they want to do it their way, they always fail. For instance, if you want to learn how to fly a plane, and if you don't listen to the instructor, if you want to learn how to drive an 18-wheeler, and you don't want to listen to the instructor, he's telling you not to drive so close to other cars. Because this 18-wheeler is not a car, it's a truck. And the instructor telling you, you have to go through many simulations before you're able to fly this plane. You gotta go through test runs. You gotta go through places where you're gonna get in the crash. So you know not to get in the crash. And you wanna do that in a controlled situation. And they have some people in life, they take that 18-wheeler and they drive it like a car. And before you know it, they're running into somebody. They're crashing. They don't want to listen. They don't want to do the principles that you need to do of God. And then you have regular Christians, if you would. They go to church every Sunday. They do all the things the pastor say do. They don't do nothing for themselves. They don't read the word for themselves. They don't pray for themselves. But they do everything. They follow all the instructions of man. And they don't do nothing for themselves. But when you go to heaven one day, when you have to see God face to face, you got to get God in your mind, in your heart, in your soul for yourself. You can't depend on somebody else. Now, in relationships, you have a relationship between a man and a woman. You have a man that's being called from God. And God has put him on a higher standard. His standards have to be higher. And then when sometimes when he conveyed those standards to his wife, sometimes she don't want to listen. It has happened before and before. And that's why you find that a lot of preachers and ministers and pastors and preachers, their marriages don't last long. Some even say, well, I can't be a pastor's wife. I can't go and do all those things because you've been selfish in your own eyes. And you want to do things the way you want to do. You don't want to do things the way God want to do. But since that man of God inherited the ability to be called of God, to do things of God, to live for God, and all those things he's being called for, being lived for, and doing for God, He's doing with all his heart. And sometimes people can't take all that pressure. They can't take all that pain. They don't want to do right. They won't do some things wrong. They want to hold on to some of the things. They don't want to just live the way they're supposed to live. And then, in essence, if you had that same man of God that inherited $80 million, that same first lady, that woman would embrace that $80 million. She wouldn't murmur and she wouldn't complain. She'll take that money and she'll enjoy that money. She'll take trips all over the world. You gotta realize in this world, if you call as a Christian, there's some things and some standards you gotta live by. There's some things that you have to do in your life. There's no shortcuts, there's no cheats. And then I mentioned on last Sunday that boyfriends don't count, or girlfriends don't count. That means you didn't commit to that person. That you didn't put a ring on it, as Beyonce would say. If you're not going to put a ring on it, we don't have nothing to talk about. We don't have nothing to say. But somebody sometimes put a cheat on it. They said, well, I know I'm waiting too long for the rent and the ring, and he don't want to do this and he don't want to do that, so I'll fall and conform to it. But I'm telling you today, this morning, if you will hold fast, if you believe and trust in God, do you know God will provide you with that thing you need, that husband you need? God will provide you with that wife you need. All you have to do is let go and let God, and everything will be in his arms. The longer you take to let go and let God into your life, the longer it takes for him. Do you want a blessing tomorrow? Or do you want to wait 6 months to a year for your blessing? I don't know about you. I want a today blessing. I want to be blessed of God right now, not tomorrow, not in the midnight hour, but I want to be blessed of God right now. And if I want a right now God, I got to let go, let God. I got to believe and trust in his word. I got to believe and trust in his name. I got to believe and know that he is God when he says he's God. Now, let me give you a story, if I would. The Bible said all are called to the glory. All, not just some, all. If you confess with your mind, your soul, your heart, and you're not playing, and you're believing and trusting in God, you're believing and trusting in his word, you will have that thing of salvation. And there's no gimmicks. There's no surround the way. There's no way out. There's his way, and only his way. It's his terms. And you gotta come by his terms, because he don't want you to hurt your body. Well, what's wrong with me having a little drink? If you drink enough, you're not going to know where you're at. It's going to destroy your body. It's going to destroy your soul. Things happen to folk when they're drunk. Things happen to folk when they don't know where they're at. He wants you to be of a sound mind, not of a confused mind, not knowing where you're at, not knowing when you're going or where you're going. In this thing of relationship, this thing of submitting to God's word, people today do not want to submit to God's word. They want to submit to their own word. And then if they say it enough, and if they do it enough, they'll believe that it is true. And just because you say it enough, just because you practice it enough, it does not believe, it does not mean that it's the truth. The Bible said that let every man find his own wife. Not your neighbor's wife. Not a friend's wife. Not a Mary Sue or Jane. Your wife. Well, Solomon had 307. Look, are you worried about what Solomon did, or are you going to worry about your soul salvation? In the beginning, I said you have to see your soul salvation. Not Solomon's. Not Samson's. Not David's. Yours. In order for you to seek your soul salvation, you have to obey the word of God. And in obeying the word of God is doing the things he wants you to do, not the things you want to do. I mean, look what happened with Jacob and Esau. Jacob's mind was made out of deception. She deceived her husband by taking Jacob to have Esau's birthright. It was never intended for him they have the birthright. It was intended for Esau to have the birthright. But that's the way the devil works. He don't want you to be who you are. He wants you to be something else in relationship. He wants you to have a relationship of your own, in your own mind, that does not make any sense. If it makes sense, he don't like it. Even the devil himself, Lucifer, if you would, he was an angel. He was an angel of music. He displayed some of the most beautiful music before God. And he loved himself so much and knew that the music was so good, he became of himself. And he was thrown out of heaven because of that. God is God all by himself. He does not need any help. And another thing, he's not a respectable person. What does that mean? It means that he don't care if you're a millionaire and you're married and have a wife. It does not give you the allowance to have a side chick. It does not give you the allowance to have another wife. He said every man have his own wife. Every man and every woman have her own husband. That means she can't go looking and trying to find another husband. Some women do that today. They marry an older man, if you would. He may be 50 years old and she's 26, 27. And when he goes off to work, if he have meetings in another country or whatnot, she go tail along with her boyfriend, which is wrong, which is adultery in her facet of life, because she committed adultery. People today want to save themselves, but they want to save themselves the wrong way. If you were running down a mountain, and then down the mountain you were running, there was a cliff of a drop-off of 500 feet down. And then you heard people hollering and screaming. You heard a faint sound telling you to stop. And you're running. And you're hearing them telling you to stop. And you're running. Two things you could do. You could listen to the stop and stop. And when you listen to the stop, and you look down, you realize they saved your life. You realize your life was spared another day. Today in relationship, people are running down a cliff. They're running down a cliff when they have a girlfriend that's not their wife. They're running down a cliff when they have a woman living like she's their wife, having children like she's their wife, but never making a commitment like she's their wife. Some men do it because they still want to have other people as friends. Some say they do it because they're afraid of the philosophy of, oh, if I get married, my parents were married and they lived a miserable life. That, and the devil will deceive you in all kind of ways. I'm here to tell you tonight. I'm here to tell you today, this afternoon if you would, that you need to let go of all these worldly things, not some of them, all of them. And you need to be holy. The Bible said, be ye holy, for I am holy. So you need to be holy. Today people don't want to be holy. They don't want to be holy. And the men want their wives to be holy. And some of their wives don't want to be holy. In their mind. They don't want to. What you mean, preacher? Why are you always telling me I dress wrong? Why are you always doing that? You see this and you see, and many preachers are telling, they're telling their wives and their members to dress a certain way. Dressing a certain way is not going to get me into heaven. It's not going to get you. That's probably right. When you say that, that's probably right. And you're probably correct on that. But when you dress with morality, you're telling yourself that you're having a shield, a covering of holiness. You're having a shield to be what God wants you to be in all aspects. Not just some, all of his aspects. That God, I want to be holy. If my husband telling me to put this on, I'm going to put it on. But she don't see it. Now this is what the man see. The woman don't see it because, oh, I'm all right. I'm okay. I'm all right. Eve felt the same way she, when she was walking in the garden. But Eve didn't have Adam tell him, don't eat off that tree. He didn't, I don't know if he did or didn't, but I don't think he was telling her every day, don't eat off that tree because I don't want to mess this up with God. You hear me? Please don't eat off that tree. I like children. I like having dominion over all the animals, the fish of the sea, all the creatures, if you would. He may have said that, but I don't know if he did. So, you have the preacher, if you would. I'm going to give you a story. This story is not true, but it's a story. It is true, but it's not true in its essence. Let's say it's a fictional story, but it's a true story, based on a true story. So the preacher man continually to tell his wife to wear this and wear that and don't do this and don't do that. But his wife don't listen. She only listens when he's around. You don't hear me? She wear whatever he wants when he's around. But when she go out with her friends, she got the Daisy Dukes on, y'all. When she go out and want to swim with her friends, she don't wear a one piece. She wear a bikini. You don't hear me? And then during the process of him traveling and going all over the world and visiting people, she developed friends. First female friends and then male friends. One thing leads to another. The Bible said, don't give place to them. Oh, she'll never do no wrong. She'll never do nothing wrong. She'll be all right. How in the world you going to live for God but not live for God? That doesn't make sense. I told you the devil would have you doing things that don't make sense. I spoke to a young lady one time, many years ago, and she was dressed a certain way. And I was just baffled in my mind that a person could dress like that in front of so many people. And I asked, I said, why do you dress the way you dress? And she told me, she was very candid with me. She said, I dress the way I dress because I'm interested. And she told me the person's name. She told me who she was interested in. And I said, what you don't understand is if when you dress that way and everybody see that and they like it, everybody want it. Not just him. And he's not going to want it. You know why? The reason why he don't want it, you see, let's tell the truth. Shame the devil. The reason why he don't want it, because even if he get it, he's going to have to do a lot of fighting to keep it. Because everybody's going to be trying. Everybody's going to be saying, look, I'm more of a man than him. Let's fist fight and see who wins. You know that don't happen in America, but that's the way the mind is. That's the way the devil work you. The devil's not going to tell you, oh, Christian man, go out and commit adultery. Go have fun with this lady. She's nice, she's cute. No, ma'am, no, sir. What he's going to do is have you go through a period of stress. And once you go through the period of stress, he's going to have you with a friend somewhere to get something in you, some liquor, beer, alcohol, whatever. You don't hear me? And when that devil gets you to get loose, you're not in your right mind. You're not at the other side. You cannot stop it because you're not in your right mind. Those things alter you. They alter your vision. They alter your body movement. You get enough liquor and you be wobbling. You be walking like this and you don't know where you're walking. You see double. All kinds of things happen. And now, you committed to something you can't get yourself out because you allowed that devil to get you. So, like I said, she told me that she was interested in one person. Now, women don't know why men are so, especially American, are so hard on women about it. The reason why is because men know how they are. Men know if they have a temper. Men know if they respond or react a certain way. They know that. But they don't want you to put them in a position where they got to take care of some business. You could be passing by walking and people look at you and the man not going to like that. Do you know men have literally gotten fist fights over other men because the way they disrespected their wife? Men have actually killed men over the things. that there was disrespect. And look, it's not to say that man is afraid. No, he's not afraid. But why put yourself through something you don't have to be put through? Do you realize if somebody else see what they like in the Daisy Dukes and they start making comments, he busts a man in the mouth, they get in a fight, he put the man in the hospital, he's getting arrested for assault? They're not going to say, oh man, you did the right thing. The law provides you to beat somebody up if they look crazy at your wife and say something. So we're going to let you go. No ma'am, no sir. They're going to lock you up just like they lock anybody else up. So the wives of ministers, make it light for the man. Don't make it so hard. The wives of ministers, encourage that man. Get on the bandwagon of Christianity, praying and fasting and believing and trusting in God. In relationship, we can conquer all things. And then we have this thing that's going on, Black Lives Matter. And then when people say all lives matter, that stimulates a person that is systemic racism. We know we hear this all the time. And people don't understand that. Well, I'm a cringe and I'm, do you know, you see, they're not gonna tell you the other side of it. Some of these white supremacists and some of these white people believe black people are not considered humans, if you would. And all of us are humans. All of us are God's children. All of us, not some of us, every last one of us. The devil's a lie. Just because the devil thought he could play that music, he thought he could be God, and that the devil's a lie. Just because you're rich and you have all this money, that gives you the room to treat people like dirt. The devil's a lie. You can't treat people like dirt. So what do you think? What do you people you think? It's Black Lives Matter. I think they do. Well, why you say that? Because the black people are the only ones that they're killing like ants or roaches. They're killing them left and right. So, of course they matter. Now, if they were doing that to the Chinese, then we would have to say Chinese life matters too. Or whites, white lives matter too. But right now, ain't most of the people getting taken out or what? Well, there you go, there's your answer. Some people are so educated, they're going to lose out on salvation because they don't know about salvation. They have this doctor of philosophy, doctor of theologian, doctor of biblical analytical studies. And he don't feel that way. He's so smart until he's dumb. You could get a woman, you don't hear what I'm saying, that has no college education, only graduated from high school, praying like nobody's business, know that word like the back of her hand. She had more sense than he could ever have in his whole lifetime. And he spent all that time going to college for, I don't know, 10, 15 years, and all his education, he still voided the knowledge of being basic, considering of another human being's life. All of us should be considered love. All of us are children of God. Well, what we should do as African Americans, we should love our neighbors. We should believe and trust in God. We should get on our knees and pray and continue to sing our gospel as we do. Continue to believe and trust in God. And God will be on our side forevermore. He'll never leave us. He'll never forsake us. And if you want things to work out right with God, you get on your knees, you start praying, you start believing in God, and God will give you the answer. Don't get the answer for yourself. Read His Word. Believe and trust in Him, and He will direct thy path. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Say it again. Thy word, come on, church. That word,
that word
that I hid in my heart.
Hear in my heart.
That I might not sin against thee.
That I might not sin against thee.
That word.
That word.
That I hid in my heart.
That I hid in my heart.
That I might not sin against thee.
That I might not sin against thee.
Again, that word.
That word.
That I hid in my heart.
That I hear in my heart.
That I might not sin against thee. Now what that mean? That means don't commit adultery. That means don't commit fornication. That means don't lie, steal, kill, and steal. That's what that means. That means seek the word of God. That means love the Lord. That means don't eat of that forbidden fruit. That forbidden fruit is your neighbor's wife. That forbidden fruit is shacking up. That forbidden fruit is drinking all that liquor where you don't have a sound mind. That forbidden fruit is, Lord have mercy, Jesus is doing the things of the world and being absent-minded of the world. If you would, can you go to Psalms 34? Psalms 34. Praise the Lord. Let's go to Psalms 34. He's a good God. Remember to let go and let God. Have God in your life. Have His word ever present. Don't let go of God. Believe and trust in His word. Believe and trust in Him. And He will definitely direct our path. And if you're in a relationship and you're married to that person, you love that person with all your heart, your mind, and so you pray with that person. You do things with that person. You see what I'm saying? Don't give place to the devil. If you're in ministry, support your spouse. Each spouse is in ministry. Let God bless you. Let God do the things you need to do. Be an offering unto God. David danced like nobody danced. His wife even got mad at him because he danced out his clothes. He said, you think that's something? I'm going to even dance crazy than that. I'm not worried about what you're saying. You got to have a heart for God like that. You have to believe and trust in His word. You got to let go of all these things in the world because they're only temporal. You fighting for a life that you don't have. Why fight for a life you don't have? All these things on this world are only temporal. They're going to vanish. And He's coming to get us like a twinkle of eye. Coming like a thief in the night. Come on now. You give the praise to God. You give the glory to God. Don't give the glory to man. Man didn't do nothing for you. And if he did, he was just being used as a vessel unto God. Don't put no man on a pedestal. God is not a respectable person. He loved you just as much as He loved me. But He wants us to be obedient servants. He wants us to be obedient servants. And that's all we have to do. We got to repent of our sins. Make a foul face on this world. This world never did nothing good for you anyway. Anything you did in your life, they're going to remember it to the day you die. What God do when you repent? He draw in the sea of forgetfulness. He wash you white as snow. It is better in your interest to have God in your life rather than have man probing on you, taunting on you, believing and trusting that you can get something out of this. Ask Anna Nicole. All that struggling she did to get all that money. She finally have access to $400 million. You don't hear me. $400 million, that's a lot of money. And what happens? Her son died, and later she overdosed, she died. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? I don't know what you're going to do, but I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. I sought the Lord, and He heard me, and delivered me from all of my fears. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all of my fears. You don't have to be afraid. God will cover you, and his word never fail. You have him forevermore. At this moment, I would like to, let's see if we can go to Special Place by Kim Burrell. Look up Kim Burrell, that Special Place. Let's play that song. Let's go out on that song in prayer. We thank you, Lord, so much for allowing us to be here Sunday morning once again, God, in your word, Jesus. We want to have a special place in Jesus. We want to believe and continue to trust in your word, in your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Jesus.
Yeah, your dreams and thoughts may cross our minds. And how to conquer them we cannot find. But somehow we find the peace that surpasses all our understanding.
Curtis Maul preach on tonight's service. I want you y'all to be a blessing. Tune in. If y'all can, we have limited seats. So when we increase our seats, we're going to invite more people as we go. But right now, we're all packed for the night. We're going to be packed for the night. We're going to have service again at 7 p.m. Be blessed. Be in the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.